Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Terry Daugherty, and I'm coming to you from the Mom's Choice Awards Studio at Book Expo America 2014. And I'm here this afternoon with Marilee McKee, author of the award-winning books Manners That Matter for Moms. Welcome to your first BEA.
Thank you, Terry. It is wonderful to be here. I've been counting down the days, and they wouldn't come soon enough until it was like a few days beforehand, and then they came too soon.
They came way too soon.
Yes. My sofa was littered. Just piles of things to bring.
Awesome.
I'm happy to be here.
Well, we're happy to have you here. And
thank you.
Be able to say congratulations in person.
Thank you.
Not just by email anymore. Yes. So tell me about Manners That Matter for Moms. Who is your audience? You know, who did you write this for?
I wrote the book for me, actually. I wrote it for me, and because I figure there are a lot of Marilees out there in the world. And so that person is a mom who sometimes doubts herself, who in the stress of everyday life, of picking up the kids, of wondering what's for dinner, of kind of feeling guilty because she went out and bought new underwear for the kids and because there's too many in the wash, it's just easier to buy some. And in the hustle and the stress of everyday life, we can forget some of the most important skills for our children. And those are the quiet skills, the ones that we don't put such an emphasis on. We put a big emphasis on getting them to soccer practice on time, getting them to dance class or karate classes on time. And yet, none of our children, if we think about it really, are going to grow up to be ballerinas or soccer players. But all of our children need to grow up and understand how to hold healthy relationships that are happy for them. Because when I look at my sons, my greatest goal in life for them is that I give them everything they need as they grow up so that when they leave my house, they can soar away. And not only will they soar, but they'll soar to a happy place. And that's done from the connections they'll make with people, not from how well they kick a ball or how well they can play. And that's what this book does. It's not an old-fashioned etiquette book where we're going to talk about tea with the queen or keeping our children quiet. I don't live in that type of home. It is a book that says, this is what matters to me. These are the things that I want my children to be able to say, my mom and prepared me for this situation and that situation. And I don't know about you, but I love being prepared for a situation. Don't throw me to the lions. Tell me what to expect so I can show up and shine and I don't have to give a lot of thought beforehand. That's what this book does. But you know, sometimes, and this makes me so sad, I do so much national speaking at Fortune 500 companies. I have seven figure executives who pay me to mentor them in etiquette. And Terry, it's the exact same thing that I teach 8 and 10 year olds in class. And the only thing I do is I put on a fancy suit and I use bigger words. Because what's correct and what connects us to another person when we're 8 or 10 is the same thing that gets us a raise, it gets a person to sign on the dotted line when we're 48 years old.
Well, it's interesting you talk about being a national level speaker and working with Fortune 500 executives and those kinds of things. I mean, have you had the opportunity to work with, you know, your target audience, your moms? I mean, how do you have the chance to speak to them?
Oh.
And do you have a program that you work with?
Absolutely, positively, because I'm a mom and I am my demographic, I speak in tons of churches across America and lots of MOPS groups. Women's luncheon speakers, their yearly conference speakers, homeschooling groups, I will come in. And yes, I speak about manners that matter to moms, and that's one of my topics, but I cover all of etiquette, social etiquette, professional etiquette, business etiquette. So I can help a mom shine as well as help her 4-year-old or her 8-year-old or her 13-year-old shine.
Well, you know, you talk about MOPS, Mothers of Preschooler Groups. How do you, I mean, in your book, do you have sort of a guided path on use this example or try using this word or language or things like that? How does it, you know, is it just a parenting book like I had, you know, the A to Z of whatever, or is it more of a guided, like a workbook type approach?
You know, it gives steps and formulas that I've developed along the way and mom-to-mom tips, but I wrote it again to myself. And so it's written in best friend style. When my friends have a question about how to handle a social situation, I'm the one that they call. Just like I have a friend who just happens to be a doctor. Well, if I'm not feeling well, guess what? I'm fortunate, I pick up the phone and I call Janet, and Janet answers the question for me. And I wanted to be the friend that if you had a question about what's the best way to handle this situation, because we all know that we want to live out the golden rule, but exactly how do we do that? You know, we're in a time of great change in our nation. Technology has flipped etiquette upside down, turned it inside out.
Well, just basic human relationships upside down.
Absolutely. Well said. And so I give that information, but in mom-to-mom ways. I share a lot of stories from my own life, and I think stories are such a wonderful way to learn because you remember them.
Yes.
You know, it's hard to remember. Okay, here are 10 steps. Please remember them in order. There will be a test later. But if I tell you it in a story, it's going to stick with you. And
well,
that's,
you know,
what
and
I
that's,
do.
And that's where memories are so important, because what I remember to do correctly came from something that, you know, like if I'm watching a movie about, I hate to say princesses, but like a princess, it goes back to stories that I already know.
No.
And you build the relationships there. I was so glad that you could join us in the studio this afternoon and tell us a little bit about your story. Thanks for coming.
Oh, it is absolutely, positively my joy. You don't know what it means to me to have earned the Mom's Choice Award. I just will carry it with me forever. It's such an honor. Thank you, Terry.
Thank you. Thanks for the kind words. It makes my day.
Oh, you're welcome. It is not bragging when it's true.
That's true.